My name is Duarte Souza. I came from Portugal, more precisely from Madeira Island, that I advise you to go there for an holidays. It's 22 degrees. It's good. I'm curious in handball. So I'd like to ask, first of all, how many of you are or were athletes or coaches in handball? How many? Oh, yes. Nice. I'm among others. Good. So, like I said, I'm curious. I was a player too, then became a coach, and there as a player and as a coach, during the process, a lot of questions were stuck into my head. So I'm trying to get some answers to that questions. This one is one of those questions. How's the influence of the center back or the central in the attack, okay? As you know, handball has evolved, and as such aspects as game, technical, tactical level, speed, and rules. This evolution provided so many changes, and we are always in constant search about what is associated to success. This led to a new approach with the appearance of new methodologies and techniques in order to get more information of the game. With this evolution, the role of the players from specific positions in attacks seem to be changing, specifically with the center back. It seems that he is more dynamic and is appearing in other fields in other zones of the field with more regularity. Last but not least, as a coach, I'm trying to assess what is the performance of my players. So, like I said, I want to see which are the reasons that teams and players achieve higher levels of performance. It's our opinion that throughout this evolutionary process, the players underwent transformations and adaptations, in not only about improvement of the game, but also specifically on the attack. I think the central back is now in a more depth role. Before, I think we saw that player like a playmaker, only a playmaker. Now it's not only a playmaker, but he shoots, he passes, he decides, yes. But it seems there's no standard player to that specific position. We saw, I will talk about this later. With this study, we intend to analyze the role of the center back and its influence in high level handball, looking for patterns of behavior. Relating this influence with the participation of offensive transition and the organization of the attack. For this, it was used observational methodology, and to record and collect data, it was created, validated, and used an ad hoc instrument, a field format with category systems. Okay, but for that analysis, it was used prospective and retrospective sequential analysis and the technique of polar coordinates. The sample was all of offensive game sequences occurred in 12 games. Each team has been observed 3 times. Before I pass to the results, I'd like to explain or give some lights about this technique. The polar coordinate technique allows to make a vectorial map. It's like a target to locate the vectors in various quadrants, determining their angles in order to establish relationship between the conducts. In this technique, that uses both prospective and retrospective analysis at the same time, the size of the vectors determines the strength of the relationship. In other words, the longer the vector, the stronger is the relationship. So here's a target. When the central receives the first pass, we try to verify what were the consequences about the result of finalization. So when you receive the first pass, its significant probability is significant probability of the team scores a goal by 7 meters. When he receives the second pass or don't receive it, it's significant probability that are no shot. So I think, like Luisa said, probably these players have better playing game intelligence. I think so, because when they decide better than the other ones. When we go to the organization of the attack, if they organize it by signs or verbally, we can see that there's differences. So when it's by signaletic organization, it's significant the probability of activate goal and shot after dribble. So as I said in the beginning, I think now they shot a lot more than a few years ago. But this inhibits the no shot and the goal by 7 meters. This one, it's the good thing. When they organized in the attack by synalytics, it's associated to success, to goal. When it's a verbal association, we can see that it's associated to simple goal, no relevance, or no shot. Probably, this is a supposition, probably the other team gets more signs about verbal than with signs. I don't know. It's supposition. When he speaks and makes some signs, normally it happens when in the attack he makes some signs and then go to one or two players close to speak. We saw three significant associations. The positive ones, weak, these ones, and again, a goal by 7 meters, and the break pass. So these are the targets. Okay. So we saw different patterns of behavior have been detected with significant probability in transition and in organized attack. I'd like to make a call to say that this is probabilistic. This is not a cause effect, okay? Given the results obtained, it is possible to state that the influence of the center back is more evident in the games when he takes part in the offensive transition, receiving the first pass. The results also show that in the organized attack, when you organize it verbally and synalytically, there's a significant probability of success. When he don't speaks or he don't make some signs, when it's associated to no success, okay? The data reinforce the influence of the center back in high level male teams, not only in the organization, but also in the finalization of the players that play in that specific position. Thank you for your attention.